is the day of independence. Ni siku ya uhuru. Independence ni uhuru. Are you sure? Ni siku ya uhuru. Amepinduliwa. Shetani ameng'olewa, amepinduliwa. Ni siku ya mapumziko, kupumzika. Kwako, jamii yako shika neno.
Amen.
Ameniuliza maswali mingi, nikufanyie nini mtoto? What can I do for you now that you have washed? You know, me, I was lost in his glory because the whole of his face was wrapped up in Shekinah. I've never seen that kind of Shekinah. Never seen. Lost in the heartbeat of Shekinah. Made of great rest, restitution. Restoration.
Amen.
According to the word of God that he has given me, and the word of God is Psalms 1:1:1. Saburi, moja. I will exalt the Lord with all my heart in the council of the upright in the assembly. Verse 2. Psalms 1:1:1. Verse 2. Great are the works of the Lord. They are pondered by all who delight in them. It is my great day. It is your great day. It's the day the heavens came to visit humanity. Divinity was great here, and we will never be the same. We will never be the same. We have been visited by the mighty, glorious, the Almighty God.
Amen.
Was here.
Amen.
We will never be the same.
Amen.
We will never be the same.
Amen.
Thank you, Shekinah.
Thank you,
Lord. Can I start? He said, praise the Lord. Parakalabroshit. I am just opening Psalms 1:1:1 now. I have not read it. I was told, as it was in 1963, when a nation that is loved by the Almighty God, Kenya, got independence. I have loved you, my children, today, because you have given me my best food. And you have given me my best food today, being the first of December 2019. And because you have given me my first food and my very, very glorious food, what can I say? That you will declare independence for you, for your generations, for your family. Lift your hands up. We are no longer slaves of fear. We are sons and daughters of Shekinah. We are sons and daughters of the Most High God.
Amen.
We are free.
Amen.
Freedom.
Amen.
Freedom.
Amen.
Is our portion.
Amen.
Freedom for our generations.
Yes.
Freedom for our nation.
Yes.
Freedom for Africa.
Yes.
Africa is free.
Yes.
Choose chapter 12. From verse 4, from verse 5. And there in heaven, the archangel Michael decided to fight with the serpent. And Satan was defeated very dangerously. She went with his fallen demons and he was held down.
Amen.
The great serpent was held down. Lift your hands up. Receive Hebrews 4. She will fight him. And he will never prevail over you and your generations.
Amen.
He will not prevail for you over you. He will not prevail over your future. He will not prevail over your families. This is the fast of December. A Satan has been fighting. His devils, his demons, his principalities, his agents, lift your hands up. They have never prevailed. And for the whole of this year, we have never parried anybody and we will never parry.
Yeah.
Why? Because since the beginning of the year, we have been hidden in the heartbeat of Shekinah.
Yeah.
That is what we do. Yeah. Clap for Jesus Christ. That is why you saw me lost. I get deeply lost because of what I passed through. I get lost in the one that I only love with all my heart, my mind, and my soul. I get so lost to the only one, the Holy One of Israel. Nothing else matters for me. That is why when I'm here, I disciple people with great seriousness. And those that have been under my discipleship have never failed. Wherever they go, into places, into places, they will always stand strong. Because they have been fortified, mentored, and mentored by none other than the Holy Ghost in me. She is holy. Holy. And so, what are the conditions of Psalms 111? For you and me, what are these conditions of independence? Right, number one, the first condition is you must have the spirit of holiness. For those that have not been here the whole of this week, we have had to repent, we have had to cry for the spirit of holiness because it was dry. I lifted my eyes and the Almighty God removed shackles in my eyes. And I could see the menorah. And I saw the river of holiness. And when I look at the river of the fear, the river of the spirit of the fear of the Lord, the last one, I was shocked. I said, Lord, what is happening here? This is missing in the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. Christians no longer fear God. They flap. They flabbergast. They do sex. Even in the church. The servants of God are sexually immoral. Majority of them are sexually immoral. Majority of them are greed. And when I say majority, I mean seriously. They are perverted, corrupt. Children of God can no longer stand still, and demons, even a smallest witch, can bind children of God. Why? The spirit of holiness, the last lampstand, is no longer there. People no longer fear God. So, because the spirit of holiness is missing in the church. It's missing in Christendom. It's missing for us individually. Even at a small demon can attack us. We are not called. We are neither called nor what? We are just dead. And so, because we are neither called nor what, the Almighty God has petted us out of his mouth. Servants of God worship things, intercessories, wherever they are, they no longer fear the Lord God Almighty. The spirit of the fear of God, the spirit of holiness from the consuming fire is no longer wrapped up in them. And so this message is no longer preached. Why? Those that are supposed to be preaching are compromised. And so power is lacking in the house of God. The Spirit of God can no longer come and do great things, mighty acts of God. Why? The Spirit of holiness is missing. And without holiness, we cannot have God. Without holiness, we cannot have God. We cannot please God. We are finished. Yes, the riters, the other rivers, the other mantles of the Holy Spirit, the other lampstands could still be in us. But when a human heart decides not to fear God, wisdom has gotten out of the door. And the spirit of wisdom also was put off by Satan. And so I saw Satan putting off the spirit of the double portion of holiness and the spirit of the fear of God. This is what I mean. This is what was put off. And so, and Satan was accusing the children of God that they no longer fear God. So he was crushing the river or the mantle or the spirit of the double portion of the fear of God. This also was put off. And this is the spirit of wisdom and revelation. But these and these were put off. The rest were burning, but have fastened. Without double portion of the spirit of the fear of God, people cannot operate well on this. All of this depends on the double portion of the spirit of holiness. Without holiness in your life, you cannot be wise. You have lost the river of wisdom. You have lost the mantles of wisdom. Without the temple of the spirit of fearing God, the spirit of holiness, the spirit of revelation cannot be in you, because revelation can be guarded and protected by the fire of God, which comes from the consuming fire. God is holy. He can never be equated to nothing else. Today, I decided to be myself. What you have sown in this house is me. That is my anointing. I was created to be like that. To cry before the Father, who I see his glory like. To worship him like that. That is me. Without restrictions, with all liberty, that is who I am. I want to be who I am. To live somebody's life. I may not pull brows because I preach holiness, but that is who I am. Holiness is what can keep the Almighty God dwell in us. Holiness is what can keep the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, the presence of God to dwell in us. Without holiness, we are finished. Holiness is right. And holiness is grace. Holiness is grace. It is a gift of the Holy Spirit. That is why it's called the Spirit. The Holy Spirit. Daddy is holy. Our Father is holy. So one condition for you to be totally independent today, before I lay my holy hands on you, number one, you must live in holiness. Holiness. And so if you are here, you're lying a little bit, you will repent after this. If you're here, you are exaggerating a little bit. That is your weakness. It has to die. God has to crush on you so that When God crashes on you, His holiness takes over. And so, if you're here and you're watching pornography, it has to crash. It has to melt like wax today. It has to melt like wax. Because I called on people to come here today that will be holy and will carry holiness with them. A little bit of pornography. So when you're having intimacy in the night or in the daytime with your spouse, and you're just doing intimacy with pornography, you are dealing with the devil himself. You are not holy. You need to be crushed like me. And so the whole of this week we have been crushed. So we decided instantly to go on a fast. And we fasted for 3 days, 2 nights. When I saw the river of holiness dry, I said, when was it? What really happened? Well, when I was walking in Kenya Commercial Bank, you will look for a holy woman and they will take you here. And surely I was holy. I was an eagle walking alone, praying alone everywhere. I used to lie low flat, worshiping God. Jesus Christ of Nazareth decided to come into this world to lie flat, to lie low. A man that was operating in the highest glory realm lost everything because of you and me. And holiness, Yeshua, he was lying flat, became a human being, wrapping himself with sin. And because of that, he was given a name above all names. That name is going to save me today. Your mouth will be saved today. Copy, it is your mouth. And so the Bible says a mouth is a small thing, just like a rudder. And this mouth can set a forest on fire. Today, the Lord will patch and the Lord will save my mouth. Say, for me and my mouth we will be saved today.
Me and my mouth.
Gossiping may have been coming from my mouth. I mean, accusation, slander may have been part and parcel of me. But from today, I will divorce for the sake of holiness. Because my Father is holy and I love him too much. I choose to be holy.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Holiness. Holiness. God is holy. God is holy. It is very hard to please God without holiness. Nobody sees God without holiness. He is a holy God. His Son is a holy Son. His Spirit is the Holy Spirit. He is holy. Write it down. You're going to read the book of Romans chapter 12 from verse 1. It says, therefore, my brothers, be as living sacrifices. Stay as living sacrifices. You are living sacrifices. You no longer conform to the world. But you have been transformed by the renewing of your mind. And so, when you are living sacrifices, number one, and your mind has been transformed, and it says, now the will of God will automatically be your portion. It means you will walk where God wants you to walk. You will walk in greatness. You will walk in adoration. You will walk in great exaltation. Why? Your mind has been transformed. Your mind has been renewed. Lift your hands up. Say, renew my mind, your Holy Spirit. Renew my mind. Make a way for me. Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus of Nazareth has been appearing to me every day. Every day. And these are the words that he has been using. I am the way. I am the truth. I am the light. Jesus. I say, Lord, you have been telling me this one. Say, when I will allow you to preach on these topics, the truth, the way, and the light, people should not miss. Yes. Romans chapter 12. As you go on reading the book of Romans, it cries of Christians renewing their minds so that the fullness of the agenda of God, the CEO of heaven, the omnipotent Father of mercy and grace, the Holy Spirit, to be in charge of the affairs of men, fully in charge, never lacking in sin. As you go on reading the book of Romans, it talks about loving your enemies with all your heart. Loving your enemies. Love those who persecute you. Do not cast them. Bless them. Romans, it's in chapter 12, verse 17, verse 14 then. Verse 14. Love them that persecute you. Love them. Do not hate them. Love them. Do not cast them. Bless them. Bless. When you bless a cast man, include an insult. And if the blessings goes there, and the cursed man is cursed, the blessings will come back to you. Hello! There is a time for Psalms 109. But always you should live in the book of Romans. Love is the greatest. When everything else has failed, including Psalms 109, when Psalms 109 has failed upon your enemies, love them. It will never fail. Oh, you didn't hear. Jesus. It says, amongst every virtues of the Holy Spirit, the greatest is love. And so, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, write it down, you're going to research. 1 Corinthians chapter 13. It talks about love. Even if I do what? Speak with the language of angels. And even the language of men. If I do not have love, I am a resounding gong. And he said, among faith and other virtues of the Holy Spirit, the greatest is love. Why is love the greatest? It will never fail. When scriptures are failed, love can never fail. I'm telling you, when your scriptures, Psalms 109, you want your enemies to die by fire, by thunder, because you are fed up with this enemy, the love of God on them will not fail. Love them. Pray for them. Pray like nobody's business. God, this person that has bewitched me, bewitched my children, bewitched my family, Father, bless him. I bless him. I bless his children. I bless him in truth and spirit. The blessings will automatically come back to you. I don't know why I'm preaching alone, but let me preach to heaven. I don't know why people don't want to say amen. Because amen, Jesus, take over.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
For the first time in my life, I am just in the supernatural. Why can't you say amen to Jesus Christ?
Amen.
Yes, that is not a good amen.
Amen.
Say amen to Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
To Jesus of Nazareth?
Amen.
Is that a good amen for Jesus of Nazareth?
Amen.
To Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Funny how these Christians love their master. I wish I was given the opportunity. A louder amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That house that has been built in heaven will not want somebody that say amen. We don't have a house in heaven. Never. I want to guarantee you. I want to guarantee you because angels that are built in that house They know two languages. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen. If you want to attract it, alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen. And if you want to walk with angels, always sing holy, 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 holy. They will come around you and they will sing with you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Amen.
The great commission is not for me alone. Father, let them all preach the gospel.
Amen.
Jesus did not die for me alone. Let them all preach the gospel.
Amen.
Powerful. Hey. So you will be telling people, amen, amen, and you feel like me. I say, as an honor, all of you will preach the gospel by fire. Yes! What is the spirit of holiness? A little bit. What is the spirit of holiness? The spirit of holiness. It is one of the seven spirits in the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Somebody has I've written a book about him. Let me just. The spirit of the fear of the Lord. I read it. If you don't have the spirit of the fear of the Lord, you can't have any of the other spirits. This is the only thing that will cut you in a fully fear of God, so that he can trust you with heavy duty wisdom. The rivers of wisdom, spirit of wisdom, revelation, counsel, knowledge, and might. That is why the spirit is the most important one, because you will be dangerous without the spirit of holiness. King Samuel missed this spirit and he became a catastrophe. He lacked the spirit of the double portion of the fear of God. At a time when he lost it all, he was just ready to kill even the animal troopers. So King David wanted to kill King. King Saul wanted to kill King David Sebai. That is an example. Any Christian, any servant of God that has lost his spirit becomes a diviner automatic. A servant of God that no longer walks in holiness. Referencing God, preferring God. You see, I prefer this God because I see him and it is just like God. Have mercy. When I beheld him, I passed, hid myself for 3 months and I told him, please don't come like that again. Don't come like that. At times I worship God alone. I worship God alone. I praise him alone. I can praise him the whole day. And at times I can feel that he is here. And all I can just have is my head moving. The rest of my body has been caught by fire, thunder, lightning. And I say, God, don't kill me. The presence of God suppresses me and puts me down, and everything cannot move. Why? I have worshipped, I have praised, I have prayed, I have waited on God. Awesome God. Awesome God. Awesome God. It's in the book of Isaiah chapter 11 verse 3. Write it down. The fear of the Lord is to depart from evil. It is the card that keeps you when you start moving in might or in the spirit of might or mighty acts of God. You need to be kept in fear so you don't get flippant or compromise your holiness. The fear of the Lord was the angel that went before Israel's tiny army. Every time when the children of God were fighting with giants, the Anakins. Giants of the Anakins. Caleb was not ready to fear them because the spirit of the fear of God was in Caleb. Joshua was not ready to back off because the spirit of holiness was in Joshua. And so Joshua could destroy. Joshua could destroy totally. It is like now, I have the spirit of holiness. I fear nothing. Right in the pulpit. Nothing. Nothing completely. When this spirit is upon you, or when this angel is around you, and the spirit of holiness is in you, there is nothing you can fear. It is an angel by itself. It takes over. Shoo! And it is rising temperatures. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Bible says, and the spirit of God, the spirit of God raises a standard. Amen. This is what raises a standard. The spirit of the power portion. Yeah. The spirit of the fear of God. Yeah. The spirit of holiness. Yeah. Holiness. Holiness. When this angel walks with me, no gun or devil can get to me. There is authority and power. When this angel comes, she will go before you.
Amen.
And the Lord showed me Christians, bound. By small witches, small diviners, and God. And I say, Lord, what is the problem? He said, offenses. What is the other problem? Bitterness. What is the other problem? Anger. With the answer. She will not be bound again by witches. There will be no sorcery whatsoever. From the beginning to the end, where God created, there will be no diviner. There will be no witches. That will bind you. Because the spirit of holiness is fire, thunder, lightning. It melts. If I meet face to face with a witch, they run. Including my own children, they run. Caroline was telling me, she just met a woman when he was just in Yalkoga the other day and asked, where is it? No. That was a witch. The devils and demons in them cannot stand a servant of God, a woman of God, or a child of God that walks in holiness. Holiness is fire, thunder, lightning. If the river dries up, devils will come sit on your chest, sit on your back, and you will begin to complain like devil. Say holiness.
Holiness.
The fear of the Lord means red. It means awe. Or to reverie. My divination would be, wow. Of God's majesty. God's holiness. God's strength. Think of His spirit as an angel called the spirit of holiness. There are times when God comes in His presence or spirit to impart supernatural grace in the power. So that we can be free of sin, this can only come out of His glory and presence. Shekinah!
Glory!
Whoever carries the glory of God must carry holiness. But when I saw the river dry, the well dry, I cried in my heart. God, when did it happen? You see, it's not only you, it is the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. People no longer dread, they no longer fear God. But from today, you and me, we will fear our Father. Praise God. Exodus chapter 20, verse 18 to 20. This is an example. Now all the people witnessed the thunderings, the lightnings, the flashes, the sound of the trumpets, and the mountain smoking. And when the people saw it, they trembled and stood far off. And Moses said to people, do not fear, For God has come to test you. And that his fear, the fear of the Lord, his fear will be before you, so that you may not sin. This is a topic that I will cover in great length because of time. Number two, the condition number two is the spirit of wisdom. Because of time, I will cover them to us as we continue. Wisdom gives us counsel in every situation to know what to do, when to do, how to do. Wisdom teaches us how to rightfully apply revelation. Without wisdom, revelation is no good. The spirit of wisdom gives us a wise and a discerning heart. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus was full of wisdom. Even as he was 12 years, note that the spirit of God, the spirit of wisdom, and the river of wisdom is not a leaf. It is not a knowledge of wisdom. I'm talking about a river that is abiding in us, lives in us. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
What are the benefits of wisdom? Go to the read the book of 1 Kings chapter 3 and 4. King Solomon. That is the first benefit you can search. When you cry for wisdom, you will find it. Wisdom, number two, will bring wealth and honor. The other benefit of wisdom instructs. I'm just summarizing points by point. Next time I will teach thoroughly. Wisdom. Wisdom protects. Proverbs chapter 1, verse 33. Whoever listens to me will dwell safely and will be secure without the fear of evil. Proverbs chapter 2, verse 10, 12. When wisdom enters your heart and knowledge is present to your soul, discretion will preserve you. Understanding will keep you, to deliver you from the way of evil, from the man who speaks perverse things. Another benefit of wisdom will bring long life to you. Proverbs chapter 3 from verse 14 to 16. For her proceeds are better than the profits of silver, and her gain than fine gold. She is more precious than rubies, and all the things you may desire cannot compare with the length of this in a right hand. Exalt her, and wisdom will promote you. Exalt her, and wisdom will bring you honor. Exalt her, embrace her, and wisdom will bless you ahead of ornaments of grace. A crown of glory, wisdom will deliver to you. Hear my son and receive my sayings, and the years of your life will be many. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 8 to 10. I will just move faster. This is what I love about wisdom. In her left hand, this left hand, there is riches and honor when you have wisdom automatically. But in the right hand of wisdom is long life. This one is given when you have the spirit of holiness. Praise the Lord. When you fear God with all your heart. You say, her ways are the ways of blessed and peace. And all her paths are peace. She is a tree of life. The souls who take hold of her. Write it down. Proverbs 3:16. The Lord by wisdom founded the earth. By understanding he established. In her right hand is riches and honor. Wisdom will prosper. On the demands of wisdom. On the demands of wisdom. I'm not going into it. It's a topic I normally teach. Wisdom. For you to gain wisdom, you must cry for wisdom. Wisdom will not come because you shout. You must cry for wisdom. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They say, I am passing in the streets of Nairobi. I am passing in the streets of your estate. I am calling for the symbol. I am calling for the symbol. My name is Wisdom. I give myself to whom is Christ for me. You must embrace wisdom. It will never embrace you. You must search. You must cry. You must race after wisdom. It will not come to you. It's one of the highest gifts of the Holy Spirit. It's the highest river. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Those are topics that will come next week. Great topics. You better be here. Let's go to Psalms 111. Two conditions I have given you. Live in holiness. Number two, seek for wisdom. Seek also for holiness. Holiness is grace. Grace is what the Lord Jesus Christ gives you. Hallelujah. You don't merit it. Our time is gone, but thank you, Jesus. First, two says, great are the works of the Lord. Psalms 111. They are pondered by all who delight in them. Glorious and majestic are his deeds, and his righteousness endures forever. This is the oracle that God has given us today, and saying it is the day of freedom for us. It is the day of freedom for us. Verse 4, he has caused his wonders to be remembered. God has caused his wonders to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and compassionate. Lift your hands up. Receive the grace. Receive the gracious nature of God. Receive the compassion of God. Freedom is your portion. Freedom, liberty. Rest, the restitution is your portion. Glorify his name. He provides food for those who fear him. God will provide food for those who fear him. And that is why the Bible says, I have been told or young, but I've never seen the righteous left without food, because the righteous fear the Lord. And so when we fear God, automatically basic necessities are provided for us. Lift your hands up. Say, Jehovah Jireh, you are my portion, and I will always cling. I will cling on you. God of Abraham, you have provided. Why is he God of Abraham? Genesis 22, write it down. Jehovah Jireh has provided. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Thank you, Jesus. He provides food for those who fear him. He remembers his covenant forever. I remember one thing, and I know it very well in my house. I am a giver of food. I have never lacked food in my house. Lacked food completely. We have never lacked food. We have feared the Lord. Now I know we have been fearing God. Praise the Lord. Both of us, the husband and the wife, Pastor Wilson, fears God so much. Hallelujah. And so because we have been fearing God, food will never miss in our house. It will not miss in your house. It will never miss forever. Praise the Lord. Basic necessities. God has to provide because of this one thing, the spirit of holiness. Lift your hands up. Father, grant us the spirit of holiness. Grant us the spirit of holiness. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Say, I repent of my sin. Wash me, O Lord, and I will be washed. Let the spirit of holiness rest in my soul today. Oh, holiness, I search for you. Please, I bind you around my life today. Oh, wisdom, I commit myself to you. I bind you around my neck. I bind you around my back. I bind you in my back. Wisdom, holiness, these two rivers, I take you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Glorify Jesus, the Lamb of God. Put your hands together. Put your hands together. This is the greatest meal that we are feasting from the heart of the Father. This is not manna from heaven. This is living bread from heaven. It is hard meat. Taken by fire, by thunder. It is working for you. It is working for you. It is working for me. It is instant. It is working from the first of this December. We already opened the gates. We have been opening the gates. We did it fully on Friday. We did it yesterday. We did it yesterday night. So the gates of December are open for anyone that has come this. The gates of prosperity, the gates of mercy, the gates of peace, the gates of prosperity, the gates of mercy, the gates of peace, the gates of righteousness, the gates of holiness, the gates of revelation, the gates of wisdom, the gates! Shakalabrokoshikirete. Lift your hands up. Lift your hands up. Say, Lord, this is my day. Man is a liar. But because you are full of wisdom, majestic in power, yet compassionate, 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 I receive your mercy. Ah, Jesus, thank you, Lord. Power is in the house. Why? Why is power in the house? The spirit of holiness, a double portion of the spirit of holiness. Glory to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. He remembers his covenant forever. The man that fears the Lord has a covenant with the Almighty God. And because God is a covenant keeping God, say a covenant keeping God. He remembers his covenant forever. Lift your hands up. I give you in the blood of Jesus totally, you and your generation.
Amen.
I put you not in the deep, not in the deep. I put you in the deepest living waters.
Amen.
You are swimming in the deepest anointing right now.
Amen.
And the anointing of the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
So because I have baptized you by fire, by thunder, and the blood of Jesus has soaked you and your generation.
Amen.
This is the covenant.
Amen.
According to the book of Zechariah, according to the book of Zechariah, praise the Lord, he rescues my children. He rescues my life. He rescues my family. He rescues my life. He rescues everything around me. He rescues my ministry. He rescues me. He rescues you from the bottomless pit. Because of the covenant of the blood of Jesus. Because of the covenant of the blood of Jesus. My God has rescued me. My God will preserve me. My God will protect me. Because he watches. He observes his covenant. Now this is the covenant. Lift your hands up. We are sons and daughters of the Most High God.
Amen.
You didn't understand. If the son is a daughter of the Most High God, it is automatic. You have been covenanted to the Almighty God. She will watch over his covenant. You and your generations will serve God. However, you will never miss basic necessities at all times. Glory by Jesus. Glory by Jesus. Whatever you see me putting on this clothing, it is dangerous. It means dangerosity has taken over. And what is the dangerosity? The oracle anointing. This is not orange. This is the oracle anointing. Lift your hands up. When it is the oracle anointing, and today being the first of December 2019, and God has given us fast of Psalms, the book of Psalms. Your life is changing for the glory of Shekinah. The glory of Shekinah. Glory by Jesus. Glory by Jesus. Somebody shout, glory by Jesus. We are almost there. We are almost there. We are almost there. Say glory by Jesus. Do I have Holy people loving, they are consumed by fire. Say, I glorify Jesus. I glorify the love of God. Majesty. Majesty. Oh. Give him praise. Follow him. Bless him. Bless him. He has shown his people the power of his works. Karabokusetan. Giving them the lands of other nations. Receive those lands. Come on. Possess the nations. Yamakova. Independence means possessing. Jesus. The day of independence had never, in 1963, it means it was celebrated by everything. Have you ever watched that day? There is no celebration like that in the nation of Kenya. There has never been. 1963. Are you getting it? Hello? It was rightly celebrated. Celebrate Jesus. It is the true one. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. The works of his hands are faithful and just. Yes. I am the work of his hands. Lift your hands up. I am the work. I am the work of his hands. All his precepts are trustworthy. They are steadfast forever and ever.
Amen.
Done in faithfulness and uprightness.
Amen.
He provided redemption for his people.
Amen.
He ordained his covenant for forever. Satan, listen. God has ordained his covenant about you forever.
Amen.
Forever.
Amen.
You're a liar, and it means you run short of memory. God has ordained his covenant for me, for my generations, forever. And so, I don't care how much you accuse and how much you lie. I don't care how much you try. God has ordained his covenant for me and my generation. I am a pillar in the house of my father. I am a pillar in the house of my father. Fortified pillar. Registered by the name, the daughter of Shekinah.
Yeah.
I dwell in the heartbeat of my father.
Yeah.
Glorify Jesus. This is the fear of the Lord. Oh, Jesus. Oh. The Father has just given the chapter. I'm just reading it now for the first time. I'm reading it for the first time. I don't remember. And what did I say of two conditions? Condition number one, the fear of the Lord. That is the river of holiness. That is the lampstand of holiness. It has to be burning throughout. It is the spirit of holiness. It has to be double portion. For you to know that the Holy Spirit is the spirit of honor. When he speaks, he gives relevant scriptures. For the word of God is living. The word of God is active. The word of God is Jesus Christ. It has to be relevant. It says, finally, first, it says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Me, I have forgotten the scripture. Please, somebody forgive me. But Jesus, forgive me the more. Forgive me that fear. What are the conditions? The fear of the Lord. Number two, the spirit of wisdom. Look, it is connected together. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And what is wisdom? So what is wisdom? If the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, so what is wisdom? Ah, 100%. Let me give you 102. 102. tout passé. Après le passé, minuscule. Après le tout, exists good. Praise the Lord. He said, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All who follow his precepts have good understanding. To him belongs eternal praise. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Realize the Spirit of God for the first time made me a lone place called in my own way. In my own way and my own understanding. Lift your hands up. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! To the Almighty God. Say, please God, please. I've never had a message like this. This message has come from you. Forgive my sins. Now cry louder.